working on this movie? Did it change your opinion in the military?
Well, I gained a whole new respect for our military personnel. I mean, I have, you know, my two older brothers were in the military. They were actually active during a Desert Storm. They didn't actually go to Kuwait, but they were on standby, ready to go. And I have a nephew that just got back from Iraq a couple of weeks ago. You know, so I've always had respect, you know, but this movie, I got to tell you, just what we had to go through in a short amount of time, I mean, really, it's nothing compared to what they go through, but it was intense.
Well, tell me what you had to go through. What did you have to do to prepare for it?
You know, training. We had a personal trainer that would just kick our ass every single day. You know, I mean, really, he made me vomit 3 times. It was really intense. A lot of cardio. So if you're not used to running, I mean, he made us run. We had to go on runs. We had to go on like a 5-mile hump with like a 50-pound pack on our backs while breaking in new boots. You know, did you know, fire team rushes. The worst was digging our own fighting hole. So with a little tool called the E-tool, which is about this big, and we had to dig like a hole that was what, like 3-4 feet deep by like 6 feet wide, but you know, with our bare hands and sleep in it all night. And then it started snowing. So yeah, it was horrible. And we're eating MREs, you know, meals ready to eat. Which, you know, little packets that you just kind of mix together and eat. That was our meals.
Well, you obviously knew it was going to be tough going into it. Did you expect it to be that tough?
I didn't know it was going to be that tough.
Really?
I got to tell you. But you know what? I enjoyed the experience. You know, and I was so honored to be working with Sam Mendes, who I'm a huge fan of. And he's one of those directors. And but also, you know, part of that was what I hated about it, because he was such a hard director. And he did like multiple takes, and he was like a perfectionist, and, you know, extreme attention to detail. So he wanted everything to be exact. I mean, from carrying actual like M16s to the actual wardrobe, to carrying our flak jackets and our gear, which weighed 50 pounds, we were wearing every day. You know, no light foamy things for us. It was the real deal. Yeah, but you know, and we're like in the middle of the rain, in winter, soaked for like 12 hours. You know, in the mud, and you know, things that you really had to go through to make it look authentic. So when you look at this movie, I tell you, it's real. Yeah.
Now, coming from a family that of the military, did your brothers tell you anything in particular that they wanted to make sure you got right?
Well, you know, they did help me. I mean, they did help me. They just, you know, they watch movies, and you know, there's always something that's never right. You know, but they were just, you know, it's the walk. You know, the confidence. There's certain swagger. The language, you know, they just want to make sure that we get it right. It's oorah, it's not hoo-ah, you know. Sometimes people get it confused. Yeah, one's Army, one's Marines.
You know? Did you read the book?
I was a huge fan of the book. I read the book 3 years ago while I was in Montreal, and I was fascinated by it. I thought it was great.
How closely do you think the book follows? I mean, the movie follows the book.
No, I think it comes close. You know, it really, it's hard to adapt memoirs into a story. But I thought Sam did an incredible job with it. You know, and I think, you know, and Jake's voiceover kind of helps you to understand where the character is. You know, and it's one man's perspective on the war. You know, so you got to kind of go into it knowing that's not every military, you know, personnel feels that way or goes through that. It's just one man's story.
So what's next for you?
Well, you know, I just finished the film with Lawrence Fishburne and Paul Walker called The Death and Life of Bobby Z. And I start work next week on a film that Emilio Estevez wrote and is going to direct, Bobby. Yeah, so well, I play one of the kitchen help. You know, there were the busboy and the dishwasher in the story. So I play Miguel the dishwasher. Yeah, who's angry, you know, just angry Chicano kind of activist who just feels that, you know, Chicanos are underrepresented and you know, he's very militant and feels that eventually one day we're going to have political power.
Yeah.
And he's right. So, yeah.